Hi, I'm Ryan. I'm at DBS Bristol and I'm doing a workshop on mixing Atmos in film. Different mixers are different. So there's a guy in particular in America who mixes in Atmos, and all of his characters are, he works in animation, and all of his characters are objects, and literally any little movement, they follow it. For me, I would like prefer a bit more traditional, where it's like pretty much up the center. If someone's like off screen, you know, really, yeah, we'll pan them off. But in terms of like panning with dialogue, one thing you need to think about is if like what format you're mixing for, and if it's just theatrical, it's fine. But if it's going to like TV, most people are going to listen to it out in stereo, and you've got to think about like folding stuff down to stereo. But yeah, for sure, like crowds, for instance, if you're in a big, busy scene and there's you're out in some like big market, you could definitely, yeah, like crowd is definitely something where you push out and make use of the surrounds, make this kind of immersive bed. But in terms of like dialogue that's on screen and big story stuff, like keep up the front and up the center, and otherwise it just becomes a bit distracting, I think. In terms of EQ, dialogue gets like butchered. It gets like I think I could get some of this up just to show you what happens. Like the main thing with dialogue, it's got to be clean, it's got to be clear. Let's just see if I can, like, you can see some of this. But in terms of dialogue, like we have different mics. So normally you have a boom and you have a clip. If you get a good boom recording, like definitely go with that because it sounds natural. And generally what you'll try and do is have the boom, and then you have the clip underneath, and you have to like phase align them, and then you have the clip to get a bit of more body. It's a bit closer and it's a bit bit more full. In terms of dialogue, you literally have to go through like line by line, and it's like matching them together to make sure, it all, because someone will turn their head and then all of a sudden they show like, so dialogue's like a very methodical process of, and it's very like technical. We've got to make sure it's just nice and clean. But then depending on what film you're working on, you can definitely get creative with it. Like if you're, obviously like, so this is, it's like a comedy, there's not anything too exciting in terms of like design stuff to do with dialogue going on. But if you're working on, I don't know, like Marvel or whatever, yeah, you can do like, or like Star Wars or any kind of sci-fi. Recently worked on a sci-fi and we were doing like, they had loads of droids. So, just making all these like wacky droid voices, which is cool, but yeah, in terms of like dramas and that, yeah, it's very just like make it clean and concise. And also dialogue editing, there's a lot in terms of you're working with the director to make sure that like the story is getting across in terms of what they're saying. And that's, you're also in charge of, how much ADR is being recorded, because if there's just a line, you can't clean it up, or if they're cutting away and they're like, oh, actually you want to change what they're saying, because now it makes more sense. We've been editing the story, now it makes more sense for them to say this. So you've got to work out, making the ADR and everything for that. What I might actually do is, just before I get into any more of this, I'm going to play a few segments. You can kind of hear what's going on. So, let's do this. So I'm not going to play that. It's about 15 minutes long. So I'm not going to play the whole thing. It'll cut into the time, but I'll just play a few bits where we've got like some objects and stuff going on. I'll get the RMU up so you can just see what's happening. And obviously, this was mixed in like a bigger theater. So in terms of like, you have all the vehicles which kind of pan past. So hopefully some of you at the back will kind of get a feel for some of that. My preference is generally keeping a character on the same tracks, but what's like in terms of track laying for dialogue, a big, well, actually anything, and when you're track laying, think about perspectives. So if I've got a character talking, or like two characters talking, and then it like there's a zoom out, pan out, and like someone else is like in another room or something going on, I want that track laid so the perspective, it's easier for me on a mixer to be like, that's on a different channel. I can just duck that down, EQ it to make it sound far away. But it also depends, yeah, In terms of like a mixer, sometimes you're just like, you're given the track layer and it's like, oh, I'll make this work, cool. But if you get, yeah, I would say just track layer everything in terms of perspectives and just make like everything as easy as possible. So I'm like, whenever I track layer effects, if I'm not mixing it, I always track layer them in the sense if I need to hand this over to somebody, like I would just want to make their life nice and easy. So, you know, yeah, dialogue is like, try to keep characters consistent and like keep all the mics on the same tracks, so all your booms on like one track, all your clips on another track, or like go like boom clip one character, boom clip another character.